Very good morning to all of you. Let us continue the discussion about the subject. We are discussing about event handling, and we have seen in the previous classes that to handle the event, the approach being followed is the delegation event model. And delegation event model consists of three main entities: the different events and different sources of the event, and then different listeners of the event. Events are generated by the different sources, and the generated events are handled by the corresponding listeners. A listener will register with the source to handle the corresponding events generated by that particular source. Now, for whatever type of events they are going to happen in the system, all the events are defined within the corresponding classes, and they are nothing but the different event classes. We have discussed about these classes also in the previous class. The different classes what we have seen were the action event class for any type of action, and the next type of event was adjustment event class, that is whenever there is a component is being adjusted. Another class what we have seen was component event class. Next, container event class. Next, the focus event class was discussed. Then input event class related with the input. The item event class related with the item, whether it is being selected or deselected. The key event is totally related with the keyboard, and it can show three types of events. That is, key is pressed, key is released, or key is typed in. The mouse event class is dealing with the operations related to the mouse, that is clicking, dragging, moving and all. Then now we have seen about mouse wheel event. Mouse wheel event is related to the wheel, whether the mouse is being scrolled, in what way we are scrolling the mouse of the wheel of the mouse. Text event is related to the text input, and window event is related with the window operation, different set of operations what we do with the window. Now, as we know, the delegation event model consists of three entities: the sources, the events, and the listener. Now, the different possible sources what we can have in the graphical user interface, that is interacting with the system by using abstract window toolkit, AWT based graphical user interface. In that graphical user interface, what are the possible types of sources which we can have in our system? The possible types of sources what we can have is the button, that is these are the list of sources what we use. So button is basically going to create some action event. That means we are going to perform some action with the button whenever a button is pressed, released and all. So checkbox is basically related with the items, that is whenever you are going to select some items or deselect some items. So all these are nothing but the different sources with the help of which we can generate the events, with the help of which we can generate the events. We can generate the events by using these different sources. So another possibility is of size. Another possibility is choice. So whenever some selected list of items are given, and whenever you are going to select some choice, or the selected choice you are going to change that. So in those cases, that is another type of event and another type of source which can generate the events. List is another source which can generate the events. That means when list of some items is given, 10 items, you will select some items, then some event gets generated. Whenever you deselect some items, then also event gets generated. So in whatever case you do, the list is the source which is responsible for generating some events. Menu item. So a menu is also responsible for generating the items. So it is going to generate the action events whenever an item in a menu is selected. Some list of items are given to you and you are going to select some items, then event will get generated. And if there is some selected item is there, if you don't want that item, you can deselect those items, then also an event gets generated. Scroll bar, so basically it is related with the adjustment events. That means whenever you are trying to adjust the scroll bar, that means basically it's related with the window. You are using the scroll bar to adjust the display area of the graphical user interface. Then text component is related with the text events. That means whenever is user is entering the character out to the text field, then the text component is going to generate the event. Window is going to generate the events whenever all the events which are related to the window. For example, window is activated, window is being deactivated, or you are closing the window, you are just terminating the window. So all these are possible sources. That means all these are the possible graphical user interfaces with the help of which we are talking to the program. Nothing but these are the entities which will allow us to talk to the Java program or to talk to the graphical user interface. Nothing but these are the entities which act as source for events. That means if you can see any of your programs, we'll be using these entities. We'll be using in our program these entities to talk to the program. For example, if you want to give some input, text input, then we'll be using the text component. If you want to create a list of items, then we'll be using the list component. If you want to create a menu driven program, then we'll be using menu item. So these are the fundamental sources with which we can generate the events. Right? Now let us see the event listener interfaces. For whatever class we have discussed, for all the classes, action event, mouse event, key event, text event, window event, so whatever events we have seen, there are the corresponding listeners for them. Because what we know is, in the delegation event model, So in the delegation event model, what happens? We will have a source which will generate some events, and for whatever events are generated, there will be corresponding listeners who are already registered with the source. They are already registered with this particular source. These listeners are already registered. They are registered listeners for this source. Now, different types of sources or event classes we have seen. That means different types of events with which user can generate or interact with the program. So all these are classes what we have seen. That is the mouse wheel event class, right? The mouse event class, then the text event class, window event class, right? So all these are classes what we have seen. That means they are responsible for generating the events. They are going to define the methods for generating the events. Now, whenever some event is generated, by the source, that must be handled by any one of the listener. That means for all the event classes, we have one corresponding listener. For class 1, we have listener 1. For class 2, we have listener 2. For example, if class 1 is for mouse event, then this listener is responsible for handling all the mouse events. If class 2 is for keyboard event, then listener 2 is responsible for handling all the keyboard events. So whatever classes we have discussed, now we have corresponding listeners. Listener is nothing but a code or block of code written for handling the corresponding event. That means what should happen in the background whenever some event is generated. That is what is listener. That means what should happen whenever I click on this minus button, that is minimize, the window will get minimized. What happens whenever you click on this icon, the window will get maximized. That means these are the events and these are the action to be done or the code to be executed at the background. That is what is the listener. Now for all the classes what we have discussed, now we are going to study the corresponding listeners. Right. So the different listeners are, for what we have seen, the very first class was action event class, and now we have the corresponding action listener interface. Action for action event, we have the action listener interface. So this interface is basically defining a method called action performed. It has one method which is going to define a method called action performed, and that is going to be invoked whenever some action event is going to be generated by the user. That means whenever you are clicking the mouse, that is one action. Whenever you are selecting some item, that is one action. So these are all, it is having only one method. What it says, what type of action you have performed, and that detail is present within this action event object. This is the object which will be containing the details of action performed by you. For example, you have pressed the mouse button, you have pressed a key from the keyboard, you have selected an item from the menu, and these are the list of different action listeners. For all the classes what we have studied, these are all the action listeners which we are studying briefly now. So it is just a only theoretical concept. That means what is the interface and what are the methods present in that one and what is the use of that. And these are the corresponding interfaces. These are the interfaces corresponding to the classes what we have studied. The adjustment listener. So as the name itself says, it is corresponding to the adjustment event class. And this interface is specifying or defining one method called adjustment value changed, and which is being invoked whenever an adjustment event occurs. For example for adjustment event is you are using the scroll bar, you are moving the scroll bar, then the for that scroll bar movement, the corresponding listener is adjustment listener interface. Next is the component listener interface. So this interface is going to define four methods corresponding to the operations what we do with the component. The different operations what we can do with the component is we can resize that, we can move it, or we can show it, or we can hide it, and these are the corresponding methods for that. That is, whenever a component is resized, this method will be invoked. Whenever a component is moved, invoke this method. Whenever a component is shown or displayed, invoke this method. Whenever a component is hidden from the user's view, then we invoke this method. So these are the corresponding methods. So this is just a theoretical concept what we are required to know. Just we should know that list of interfaces, what are, which are called for the corresponding action events, for corresponding events. Next is container listener events. As it is corresponding to the container event class. So this is going to create two methods. So the two methods are, so what we can do with the container? The container, we can either add the component or we can either remove the component. So as we have seen, if you assume this as the container, what we can do, either we can add a component, add a component or remove a component. For these corresponding events, for addition of an component or deletion of an component, it's going to define two methods. What are the methods? Component added is called whenever you add a component. Component removed method will be called whenever you remove a component from the container. And these are the definitions for those prototypes of those functions. Whenever you add a component, this particular method will be invoked by the container listener interface. And AE, this CE contains the object. Object which has generated the event. Similarly, the focus listener interface. So as the name itself says, this is related with the focus gain and focus lost of a particular component. That means whenever a component is going to obtain the focus, then focus gained event will be called. And whenever a component is going to lose the focus, then focus lost is called. Specifically, we are concentrating here, we are taking example of keyboard. That means whenever a component is gaining the focus of the keyboard, then focus gained is invoked. And whenever keyboard focus is lost, then focus lost method will be invoked. Say for example, this has lost the there is no focus of the keyboard now. If you want to, if for example, now I have clicked on this, now I am entering the character. That means this particular component has gained the focus of the keyboard. That means now with the help of keyboard, you can give input to the program. So this we are creating practical programs later. Now we are studying theoretical concepts. Practically, program will create. I'll run the programs and I'll show you the graphical user interface, how they are going to work. Now, item listener interface. So this interface is defining one method called item state changed, and which will be called whenever the status or the present status of the item will be changed. It has one method, and this is the corresponding prototype. The listener interface. This interface is basically defining three methods, and it is the key listener interface. As the name itself says, it is dealing with the different events which can be generated by the keyboard. And we have seen in the action event, keyboard can generate three types of events: key pressed event, key released event, and key typed events. And these are the corresponding methods which will be called whenever the corresponding events are taking place. So we have seen in the previous discussion that pressing and releasing a key may not produce the character. For example, Alt, Control, and Shift. So whenever you press and release, what happens? If a key is appearing onto the screen, then all the three methods are being invoked. Whenever you press a keyboard, and whenever you release the keyboard, and in this case, what happens? All the three methods will be invoked. For example, key pressed, type, and release will be invoked whenever key is appearing on the screen. If after typing some key from the keyboard, if the character is not appearing on the screen, say for example, home key, whenever you press the home key, or alt key, control key, shift key, all these are not going to generate the character. Say for example, here I am going to type a character called yes. But three methods have been invoked now. What are the three methods? Key pressed, key released, and key typed. All have been invoked. For example, now I am pressing control button now. So I am pressing control button, alt button. What are the events which are taking place here? The events which are taking place are only key pressed and key released. But key typed is not taking place. Why? Because key typed will occur only when some character is appearing onto the screen. And these are the corresponding prototypes of the methods. Key press, key release, and key type. Now, mouse listener interface, as the name itself says, it is the listener for all the events generated by the mouse. That is what there are the different things that we can do with the mouse. Either we can click the mouse, in that case, mouse clicked method will be invoked. Or a mouse can enter into the corresponding region, then mouse entered event method will be invoked. When mouse has exited the graphical user interface, then mouse exited event will be invoked. Whenever you are going to press a button onto the mouse, then mouse pressed method will be invoked. Whenever you release the button, then mouse release button will be invoked. And these are the corresponding prototypes. So we'll be discussing all these methods in the programming example. We'll see what happens, how the methods are being invoked, and how do we write the definitions for these methods, and how they are going to help. Mouse motion listener interface. So it is basically related with the movement of the mouse. The two types of movements we can do with the mouse, that is mouse dragged and mouse moved. I have explained the difference between mouse dragging the mouse and moving the mouse. This is what I am simply moving the mouse without pressing any of the keys. Now, if you press a button onto the mouse and move, then it is called as dragging a mouse. So dragging a mouse is different, and moving a mouse is different. And these are the corresponding prototypes of the functions. Mouse wheel listener. So this listener is responsible for observing the wheel movements, whatever mouse wheel we have. So this has only one method called mouse wheel mode, that will be invoked whenever there is a movement with the mouse. The text listener as it itself says, the name says, this is the interface which is responsible for reading the text value. That is, whenever there is a change in the text field, this corresponding method will be invoked. The window focus listener. So this is responsible for two types of activities what can take place with the window. A window can either gain the focus or it can lose the focus, and these are the corresponding methods for that. Next is the window listener interface. So window listener interface is responsible for seven types of methods. So the corresponding methods are called based on the type of event which is going to take place, that is, whenever window is activated, whenever window is deactivated, or window is iconified. So window is deiconified, then window is opened, or window is closed, and window is closing. Closed and closing. So these are the corresponding prototypes. Right. So these were the different methods, different listeners for the different types of events.